Look at that thing. Don't worry, we're in a straight line. We can't hit anything. Don't burn me down. What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, the Slab Train, and welcome back, guys, to some more Forza Horizon 2. Now, today, we are back in our Subaru, guys, and we're going to be completing some of the more races that we do have left. Now, oh, yeah, this thing rips, bud. Holy shit. Now, going back to last episode, I asked you guys in the comments to hashtag ask slap your questions that you guys had for me. Now, we had a lot of questions. I'm going to answer a couple of them in this video, but if they are not answered, guys, this is what I would like you to do is either A, wait for my comments back. If I comment back and answer your question, then there you go. If I don't, then please, guys, just leave it in the comments in this video here. It is very tough for me to answer, you know, every question that I have in one video. I got shit to do, bro. You know what I'm saying? I can't be doing that the entire damn video. So we are going to be getting through a couple of them. That thing handled nicely in that little patch right there. Here we go. Man, this Subaru is a beast, though. I'll tell you that right now, man. My bad.
400 yards, turn right.
We got it. Now, I just came home, actually. We just went to the pumpkin patch, man. Me and my girlfriend went out to, I think it was around Niagara area, and we went to pick a pumpkin, man. I mean, it wasn't exactly what I expected. I was expecting to actually go out into the patch and, you know, pick them up, but they had a, you know, whole slew of pumpkins there. They had some hay bale rides. They had some haunted houses. They had a lot of stuff. They had pig races, too. It was absolutely insane. And I don't know if you guys as well, too, are going to be carving pumpkins this year, but I would love to see your guys' creations. Make sure if you guys do make a pumpkin this year, which you guys better be doing, man. I'm making my damn pumpkin this Sunday. And if you guys do get a pumpkin and you guys do carve it, make sure you guys send me a damn picture of it on Twitter at slap_train. I would love to look at some damn pumpkins, man. If you guys, you know, if you guys have any car manufacturers or anything car related in those pumpkins, you know what I'm saying? Bonus points to you guys. You know what I'm saying? Oh my god, man, it'd be absolutely crazy. Now, alright, so the first comment of the day is coming from Jay Fanada, and he says, "Ask Slap, I was wondering if you could roll around in your Infiniti in Forza Horizon 2 and tune it up and see whether or not it's similar. And of course, drift." Now, unfortunately, my man, there is no damn G35 in this game. Otherwise, I'd be pretty damn excited. Now, we're going to be playing on Unbeatable for today. I really want to see if this Subi can hang up. And next comment is coming from Sha Rosie, and he says, "Ask Slap, how did you get the name Slap Train 1? So, two different answers for this. One is my YouTube name. The Slap Train 1 came from the Slap Train being taken on YouTube. I don't know who the hell did it, but somebody stole the Slap Train on YouTube before I started it. So I don't understand who the hell would have done that, man. You guys are sick, you know what I'm saying? Why would you do that? Oh, shit. We got it. This thing's a beast. Probably not going to be as beast as everybody else in the pack, because look at this, man. We are falling behind real quick right now. I don't know if that was from my sloppy driving right there. All-wheel drive. I'm going to use this to pull us through. Now, my gamer tag, though. That's it. Alright, we're going to put this on pro. This car is not acceptable for what we're going to be doing. So, we just don't have a tune. We don't have proper horsepower. This thing is going to get absolutely demolished in this lineup. So, we're just going to put this back to pro, and that should be okay. So, the Slap Train, it's kind of a funny story. I mean, the Slap Train just kind of came about playing with some group of buddies and just having a good time. We were actually just playing Call of Duty one night, and, you know, we would always rattle kids. We would always get people, you know, just talking trash, having a good time at night, shotguns, you know, claymores, whatever need be. We would be those guys causing ruckus, you know, after a long night of pub stomps and stuff like that, too. So, you know, one night we were playing, and I think it was one of the maps that had the train. And I think I went 6-0, and the train went by, and I just, you know, it clicked. I was like, oh, man, you guys got slapped, and then the train went by, and then it was Slap Train, and then somehow somebody was like, hey, man, you should, you know, make your gamer tag Slap Train. And I'm just like, oh, my God, you know what, I'm going to do it just because it's pretty damn funny. You know, it's different, it's unique, and I rocked that for a long time. And,
get off me, Brett.
Ooh! That was a damn tree right there, too. And I rocked that for a long time, and it wasn't until a couple months after that I started doing YouTube. And I started doing YouTube, and I had a couple different tags. I was Deluxe for a little bit, but majority of it, though, Slap Train just came from Call of Duty and just playing with buddies. And that name resulted in just having, you know, years of fun on Call of Duty with the same guys and, you know, just enjoying myself playing for the fun of gaming. And, you know, that's kind of why I like the name, is just because it's not something that, you know, it's Drift King or, you know, it's something else. The name is real, man. I came from literally having fun and just being myself, playing with some buddies, and I don't know. I mean, it's different. It's very awkward telling people my gamer tag. I'll tell you that right the hell now when I'm sitting there, you know, man, what's your gamer tag? I'll add you up. It's just Slap Train, you know? I got, you know, Slap Train. You know, I have to kind of say it underneath my breath sometimes. It's a little embarrassing if you're talking to someone that you don't really know what the hell is going down. They're just like, okay. But, yeah, I mean, the name has just come from having fun, man. Having fun playing with your buddies. And that's kind of the main reason why I do enjoy it. Obviously, we are way too late. We are way too late to turn back and, you know, change it up. So, you know, I am very happy with it. There's many different ways that we can, you know, pursue the name. It could be a tandem train slapping each other's damn bumpers. I don't know, man. But that is the story behind the name. Not very much of it. It's just kind of it happened. And you know, that's all sometimes right, the greatest names. Win. We're gonna take that W though. Give me those 20 points, my man. And we're gonna get on to the next damn comment. So my phone is being extra damn sluggish today. I did save them on my phone, like I told you guys I was going to, man. I did. So this one's coming from Sean Prickett, and he says, ask Slap, what do you use for your daily in the winter? Now, funny story, true story, actually. I heard it from a friend of mine. And I'm going to be driving the G-Series for the winter. I'm getting 4 fresh snows put on it, and we're going to be having some fun in the winter, man. Now, obviously, with driving a rear-wheel drive car in the winter comes with great responsibility. I mean, you got to understand you're dealing with almost 300 horsepower to the wheels. Well, not to the wheels, but probably about 260 to the damn wheels. But it's a kind of a heavier car, and it's rear-wheel drive. And, you know, cars can slip out very, very easily. And, you know, especially in the wintertime, especially out in Canada,
turn
eh?
Around.
So, you really got to be careful, and this is going to be something brand new for me this year, driving, you know, a rear-wheel drive car in the winter. I was driving my Malibu for the longest time in the winter, and that was my winter beater when I was driving my CRXs. Left. So, that was my winter machine. Now, this is going to be the first time I've ever driven a rear-wheel drive car in the summer, or in the winter, sorry. So, I got to experience it for the summer, had some fun with it, I think I'm ready for winter, I really am. I mean, I've kind of, I ain't even gonna say it now. I am ready for the damn car for winter, let's just say that, alright? Now, can we get through this right here? Come on now, please. Yes, look at that, that's cheating right there, we cheated the system. But we're gonna take it though, give me my damn Subi. So yeah, so that is going to be my daily for the winter. Obviously, I'm not going to be driving it if it's damn, you know, negative 20, snow, storm, hail, whatever. I can take the bus for that. It's not a problem. I get a bus pass free with school, so I ain't even tripping, bro. Now, S-Max says, ask Slap, does your clutch work with the paddle shifters? Have you ever thought about doing a community build, such as putting in your video which car, then after what rims, body kit, kind of build, drift, drag, cruise, and one of the requests, can you do an MK2 Ford Escort or Ford Sierra? Okay. Now, I'm pretty sure I already did the Ford Escort for you, my man. Now, in terms of... Man, we're in third gear right now. We're just going to restart that. Now, in terms of the clutch, yes, it does work with the paddles. Now, if I do have the clutch engaged... Sorry, the clutch turned on with manual shifting, I actually have to use the clutch with the paddles, otherwise it's not going to shift properly. So you do get a faster shift when you are using manual with clutch with the paddle shifters than you would, you know, a regular paddle shift. Come on now, we got a little bit of rain here going on. Then we have 245s in the front on this thing, and I want to say another set of 245s in the rear, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, though. I've been wrong before is what I'm going to say right now.
Excuse me!
He's trying to get through right now. He's trying to make a living. Yep, appreciate it. 18%. Look at this going through. I wasn't even damn nervous about those trees. They're like paper to us. We're just going to get a little sideways right now because we can. Look at this.
That all-wheel drive life, baby.
Only knocked down one pole. I ain't even scared, though. You know what I'm saying? Look at that. We're still gaining, damn. Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. No. Okay. That's our problem. I got this. 35%. We got lots of time, guys. Just a matter of fighting this rain right now, man. Now, I wonder if I can get another comment as I'm driving. That will be impressive. Let's try it.
Oh, this one's coming from Blar, man. This is tough.
Do you ever think you will do a video with that dude in blue? You and him. I think he said my favorite YouTubers. So, in terms of a video with that dude in blue, I definitely would love to get a video going with him. That is definitely on my bucket list for my YouTube, career, you could say. We got, not a video, but we did get a stream with my man Val Dudes. That was awesome. If you guys did miss that, I did put up a video, where we did drift and, you know, cruise out together. So if you guys missed that, go and check out that live stream, but that was a hell of a lot of fun. And yeah, I mean, I would love to cruise out with that dude in blue, rip some damn tandems. I know he's very busy, and that's a problem with YouTube, man, especially in these months. I mean, you know, summertime's a lot different. Everybody's usually kind of doing their own thing. They're off. They got lots of free time. Stop breaking, my man. But, when it comes to, you know, him at least, he's doing a lot of recording. He's doing a lot of editing. He's working his ass off. And, I mean, you guys can tell in the videos that he's doing. There is no damn quality lack in his videos. Even, you know, his rally videos. You can tell his voice is about to damn just give out. He's ready to just pack it in, man. His voice is about a damn one word away from just going, no, I'm done, and just, you know, cutting out. But he's excellent been still driving. Going with it, another and he's been win. Going strong, and, you know, I give my respect to him grinding it out, and he's doing a hell of a job on his channel. So, you know, respect to him for, you know, keeping up, and definitely, I called it, man. I seen him come up through the damn ranks, and I really did call it. I was like, man, this guy's doing big things. He's going to be surpassing me any day, and, you know, I think a month, 2 months later, he was at 80K, and then he was at 100K, and now he's at, what, 150K? The guy is skyrocketing, man. I would love to be up there with him, and that's hopefully the plan this year, because we are skyrocketing as well, too, and I'm absolutely just blown away by the amount of subscribers that we've gotten in the last couple days, man. Oh, we got a Jaguar E-Type. Okay, $157,000 in prizes with $82,000 cash prize. Okay. Now, Alexander Hobblestone says, what do you feel would be your next car if you can pick one right now? And what are your plans for the Infiniti? Now, I was going to talk about... Oh, we got another damn prize? Let's go, bruh! Oh! Give me another car. Come on. I knew it was going to happen, man. So, first, I forgot the damn question. I swear to God, I have short-term memory loss. If I could choose another car right now. Now, let's just say everything aside, because a lot of people don't take into consideration insurance, you know, gas, all that stuff. You know, cost to fix the damn thing. Putting all those aside, something that, let's not even say reasonable price. Let's just say anything, really. It's very tough because there's a lot of things that are going through my mind. Let me just shoot out the cars that are coming to me right now. 70 Chevelle SS, 454, S13, hatch,
oh shit,
R34, Aventador, Dodge Viper, I'd have to say a Nova. I'd take all the damn muscle cars in the world. All of them. Give me them all, man. Come on, man. It's like damn Pokemon, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, there's that. What else catches my damn eye right now? Oh, that beautiful RX-7. Oh, my God. There's so many, man. 350Z, 370Zs are absolutely gorgeous. I think they're only like 40 grand, too. So they're definitely reasonably priced for a $40,000 370Z. Actually, the guy that goes to my gym has one. And he knows he's got a fresh-ass car because he parks that bitch in no damn parking spot. That thing is at the front of the building next to the closest parking spot. That's how much this guy is like, yeah, man, my car's the shit. What's good? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how he is. I don't know if he runs the damn
next
place
up,
or not,
hill
but...
climb. You might not need as much brake on uphill turns, so let gravity do the work and give yourself the best speed through the corner.
Now, in terms of plans to the infinity, now... there's really not much that I want to do. There's not much that I really want to do to the car. Just because... I'm starting in third gear again. I cannot believe that. Just because of the fact that, you know, the car is already gorgeous, man. There's nothing really that I want to do except for next summer. You will see a new damn gear shifter before then, for sure. You will see new rims and tires. And possibly, depending on, you know, how much gap there is with the new rims and tires, a set of coilovers. Now, that's, you know, that's best case scenario. Worst case scenario is only rims and tires with the gear shift. And then, you know, with that as well too, I would love to dress up the engine bay with a carbon fiber valve cover, the big plastic piece that goes around there. What else was I thinking? Obviously roll bars and such like that, reinforce the chassis, new exhaust. List can go on and on, man. It's just a matter of, you know, money and if I would have it at that point in time. So it's gonna really come down to that. Oh, we are rallying this bitch though. Look at this, man. Oh, we're on that damn man's bumper right here. Alright, here we go. Get a little contact on the right. It's all good. Take this extra wide. Woo! So just slide it out. Rip it. This thing is just mint, man, in the dirt at least. It is just an absolute monster. Oh, yeah, that's a bush. We got it. This car requires concentration in the dirt, man. You never really know where you're going. So, because I need all the concentration that I need, we're going to read another dumb comment as we are driving right now. Oh, yeah. I need more horsepower. Oh man, I thought I could rip that whole thing right there. If we had only a little bit more torque and horsepower to that thing, it would have been absolutely vicious damn U-turn right there. Or a hairpin, or whatever the hell you want to call those. Oh man, I can only imagine how this would feel in real life, man. All-wheel drive, 350 horsepower, Subaru STI, oh my god, man. Look at these corners coming up right now, look at them. Oh man, I got distracted by the corners coming up. This is going to be hella fun here. Alright, here we go. We're going to rip this in second, or maybe even first. We're going to rip it in first. Second is going to be definitely the gear. That was absolutely horrible. Man, I didn't even know this section existed, though. Get it! Let's see how this looks in third person. Boom, bruh! Get it! Call him a cray status right now, man. Let's go. Rest in peace, my dude. Oh, man. As much as people rip on all-wheel drive, nothing is damn, you know, funner than throwing it out on a dirt road and just having a good damn time with it. We're going to come across this finish line with ease. Look at that. We're going to do a 362. Don't touch me, my man. Look at that. Coming through, gorgeous, man. Absolutely gorgeous. So, Maggie Wong says, what is my dream car? Kind of just mentioned that. It'll have to be probably a Chevelle for sure. Danny Crash Test says, have you ever thought about trying to drift? Every day, my man. Every goddamn day I want to go to the track and slide this thing out. But, you know, you got to keep it on the track, and that's where it stays, you know what I'm saying? Next up we have...
So take that as a compliment.
Hey, Ben, shut up, man. I'm trying to talk. So, Slab, how old are you, and what's your favorite food? And this actually says this, all right? It says, and piss give a shout-out for me. Please, love you. Awesome. Slab. I'm pretty sure I meant to say please, but it came out as piss. Appreciate it, my dude. Maybe that's an L. I can't see. It looks like piss, all right? That's all I got to say. So, I'm 23 years old, my dude. And my favorite food. Ooh, god damn, man. You're throwing me hard ones today. I'd have to say, man, I love pizza, but that's so overrated, though. I'm a really big salad person. I don't know what it is. I love salad, steak. I don't know. I'm all. Oh, what the hell? Rate it. Let's go. I love casseroles. Oh God, I may have to get a damn 7-layer casserole after this bitch. Cracker cake. Oh my God, the list goes on, guys. Oh, what else can I say? You know, steak, T-bone, same damn thing. Spaghetti. Oh, could go for spaghetti right now, man. You know what? Fire up the damn stove. I'm making spaghetti after this bitch. Alright, Marcus Cunha says... Alright, no, that's not even a damn question. That's a damn time spot right there.
Okay, some great racing
Ooh,
today. But before we
the
move
cargo.
On, meet me here. I have a little something special planned.
The cargo plane. Guys, I've heard about this shit. Storm Chaser. I heard this thing is absolutely crazy. How far away are we from it? We're not that far, guys. We gotta do it, man. We can't end it this early. It's only 20 minutes. You guys would be cheese at me if I missed that one. This is, I've been told, this is one of the biggest showcase events that is here. Like, just in terms of, you know, what goes down. A cargo plane? That's actually fitting because I seen a cargo plane flying around today. I don't know what it was. I was outside doing some cleaning up in my placement, and this thing, like, flew by this place, like, at least four times. It looked like something out of Grand Theft Auto 5, man. It was crazy. Look at this, 0.5 miles. Let's go. Oh, we're hauling. We're not actually hauling that much. We're only going 150, which is actually really fast, though, in kilometers. It doesn't feel like it, though. All right. Here we go, man. I'm excited. Storm Chaser. Oh, man. How many more comments do I got? I think I got another one here. Stone Sheldon says, would you ever consider doing a road rally like David did? Love you, my dude. Keep up the good work. Well, shit, man. Appreciate it, my man. In terms of a road rally, hell yeah, I'd be down to do that. It's just a matter of finding one in my area. There's really not a lot that goes down in the GTA area where I live, so... Oh my God, that thing is huge.
Just remember, you both have to hit all the same points, and the turning circle on that thing is huge.
Right, that thing is huge, man. All right, here we go. We're driving the Jag. Oh, bro, I cannot wait to slide this thing. Where is it? Where is it? I can hear it, man. Oh, shit, there it is. All right, that thing is big, man. Look at that bitch, though. Let's try to get a closer look. Shit! That was too much close. All right, we're going to restart that. I thought I was going straight, guys. I'm sorry, man. I know half of you just went, oh, my God, slap. I'm sorry. All right, this is our time to shine right now against this big bitch. This is a big bitch, man. Look at these chicks. They're damn standing in the rain. See you later. You get my damn bitch. All right, where are you at, bro? All right, eyes on the road this time, guys. You can look at it. I gotta focus. There. Oh, baby. This thing is big. Look at that thing. Don't worry. We're in a straight line. We can't hit anything. Boom. See you, my dude. All right, here we go. This rain, though, is vicious. Oh, we're gonna take out some pills. Oh, bro, that thing is insane. We got it. This thing has got some balls, though, man. This thing is hella damn quick. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, yo, look at this. We are killing this thing right now. Oh, no, we're in second. How are we in second? We won't tap that thing, man. That was insane. We're going to try not to slide this out as much as possible. Just because this is going to be... gaining some serious speed on us. Look at that thing, man. That thing is one giant ass damn cargo jet. I wish we could fly it. Come on, turn 10. Update us, man. Let us fly that big thing. It'd be crazy, though, wouldn't it? Be able to fly everything in there. Oh, take it easy. We're passing this thing. Come on, let's get this in the view, man. So glad I looked at my map right there. That would have been very bad. Look at how slow that thing turns. Oh my God, bro. There we go. 52%. Look at that thing, man. was our turn. There it is. Oh, smooth, man. That's silky right there. That's silky.
Come on, hold it.
We got it. We got it. Oh, bro, we're getting... Oh, my God. Off-road time? I'm not about this life. At least not this Jag, I know. Oh, my God. What the hell is that damn pilot doing, man? Little correction. That's where I need a damn handbrake right there. I had to find it as the wheel was spinning. That was tough. It's all right, though. We got it. That's why we damn... That's why we out here in the streets on pro. Oh, bruh. This thing is just so slidey right now in this weather, man. They did this on purpose, man. They gave us this beautiful Jag. Not too much. There we go. This thing is just hauling some serious ass. Now, as well, too, guys, if you have any more questions, like I said, leave them in the comment section below with hashtag AskSlap. And a lot of people are asking about my Facebook group and the drawings and such. If you guys do have some drawings that you guys would like to submit for the start of my videos, all you need to do is just join up on my Facebook group and submit them right there. This is the last stretch. Holy shit. Come on, baby. Oh, bro, it's like Fast and the Furious. Come on. Oh, yeah, we got it. No problem. Woo! That was crazy, though. My hat is off to Playground Games for having some immersive damn showcase. Chasing him down. Okay. That XKR, though, is vicious, man. I wish we got to keep that thing. But now that we've driven it, I may have to buy it, though, just because it's how damn beautiful that thing is. So we're going to walk away with 8,000 XP. That's going to be enough to level us up and a wheel spin. Oh, my God. Give me that damn money, man. How much we got? Race Arrival. No thank you, King Julian. Oh, King Julian. I love that movie, man. I'm going to be seeing Madagascar Penguins or the Penguins of Madagascar. It's going to be awesome. If you guys are going to be seeing it, let me know. I'm excited. I'm excited. All right. This loading screen is enough, man. I want to see my damn wheel spin. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, make sure you guys slap that damn like button. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys don't forget to hit that damn subscribe button too, man. There's a lot of buttons, I know. Just hit them all, man. Hit those all, man. Start spinning some rubber with us as well, too, if okay. You guys... Nah, Ben, this is not the time.
Head on up to the hub when you're ready to move on, and we'll start the next leg of the road trip.
I appreciate that, Ben. Thank you so much for interrupting me. Like I was saying, though, if you guys are not already, make sure you guys follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all of which are found in the description box below. Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Slap Train. I'm out. Peace. We got the damn Lancer, man. Let's go, baby. Don't burn me down.